Last class we have learned about communication at workplace and interpersonal communication skills. In this lecture class we learn about group discussions and employment interviews. We learn about group discussions, what are group discussions and employment interviews. Group is a collection of individuals who have regular contact and frequent interaction and who work together to achieve a common set of goals. Here the word group. What is group? Group is a collection of individuals who have regular contact and frequent interaction. They interact now and then and works together to achieve some common goals. And discussion. What is discussion? Discussion is the process whereby two or more people exchange information or ideas in a face-to-face situation to achieve a goal. Here, what is discussion? Discussion is the process where two or more people exchange the information or ideas in a face-to-face situation. They sit together and they exchange their ideas to achieve the goal. The goal or end product may be increased knowledge, agreement leading to competition or resolution, or perhaps only a clearing of the air or a continuation of the status goal. So here goal can be anything. It may be increased knowledge or agreement leading or competition or any kind of thing which is said to go ahead. Who holds a group discussion? So what is group and what is discussion you have come across? Group is nothing but it is a collection of individuals who have regular contact and they interact often. And discussion means it is a process where two or more people exchange information or ideas to set a particular goal, to achieve a proper goal. So now, who will hold this group discussion? What is a group discussion? Group discussion properly labeled as GD. It is a popular methodology used by many organizations. Here, group discussion popularly labeled as GD. So we don't keep calling as group discussion, we just call in short form as GD also. It is used by many organizations use this group discussion. Companies, institute, business schools, etc. So in many companies, many institutions and many business places and schools use this group discussion. These tests to gauge whether the candidate has certain personality traits such as interpersonal communication skill, confidence in public speaking, team spirit, leadership abilities, social behavior, and problem solving skills. So these are the important things to test nowadays for the candidates, whether they have got the proper personality traits such as interpersonal communication skill, or they have the confidence in public speaking or team spirit, or how far they are good in leadership qualities and social behavior and problem solving. So for this purpose, group discussion is held in most of the places and organizations. GDs form an important part of the shortlisting process of recruitment or admission in a company or institution. Here, group discussions plays a very vital role in shortlisting for recruitment or admissions in any companies or any institution also, because they want to see the caliber or the ability of a person there, like how good they are in speaking or listening or building competition or maintaining the leadership skills. All these things they are going to rule out. It is a systematic and purposeful interactive oral process. Here, the exchange of ideas, thoughts and feelings take place through oral communication. So here, what happens? It is a systematic process, purposeful interaction which happens, and the ideas, thoughts and feelings takes place through oral communication. Why oral in the sense? Because this is group discussion. It is a discussion of people among the group where oral discussions happens. So why this group discussion takes place? What is the aim of group discussion? The objective of a group discussion is to evaluate certain attributes in a candidate that can be otherwise difficult or time consuming to ascertain panelists or evaluators in a group discussion will look out for communication skill. See, this group discussion helps the panelist or evaluator to find out how the candidate is good in. Otherwise, after appointing, after giving a job, they may face difficulties. So instead of that, group discussion will be held during the interviews or during admissions. Okay. And it will serve the purpose for the panelists and evaluators. So what is the purpose of GT? So what is the purpose? Why group discussion is held? What is the purpose of group discussion? Group discussion serves several purposes. Breeding fresh ideas and taking inputs from a particular group. The first point is here group discussion serves many purposes, like breeding fresh ideas and taking inputs from the different groups. From a particular group, they will get different ideas. Perception of common people on a particular topic, identify a solution to a specific problem or issues, selecting candidates after the written test for hiring in a company. So group discussion plays a major role here. Like they can get idea from a particular topic. They can get idea from a particular topic, particular group, and they can identify a solution to a specific problem or issues. So it will be easy for the organization to hire a candidate in a company after conducting this group discussion. Key points in group discussions. So what are the main points you have to remember while you are undergoing group discussion? First is pay attention to your body language. This is very much important. Pay attention to your body language. Be courteous with fellow speakers. Be confident and keep adding good points. Ensure that your words make sense. Don't be afraid to start. Follow your heart. Stay updated at all times. So these are the main points which you have to keep in your mind. What are the key points in group discussion? What you have to come across? What you have to know about this? First thing is pay attention to your body language. Body language matters more here, because it is interpersonal skill. As I've already explained in the last class, interpersonal skill matters here. Body language in the sense your gestures. So you pay attention to your body language. Be courteous with fellow speakers. You must be careful with your fellow speakers whom you're talking with. Be confident and keep adding good points. You must be confident and must keep adding good points. Ensure that your words make sense. While you are undergoing group discussion, be sure that your words make some sense. Don't speak irrelevant talks which are not related to the group discussion. Don't be afraid to start. Some of us will have starting problems, so this is very much important. So don't get scared. Don't be afraid to start. There's no need of panicking. Follow your heart. Speak what your heart says. Stay updated at all times. So when you enter into group discussion, stay updated to the topics all the times. Next is follow these group discussion rules. So what are the rules you have to follow? First is come prepared. So when you're coming for a group discussion, come prepared with the topic or with yourself. Note down the names of all the participants. Maintain a firm posture. Take charge of the discussion. Retain your standing and balance. Do not get emotional. See what rules you have to follow. Follow these group discussion rules. First thing is, you must come prepared when you are entering for a group discussion. Note down the names of all the participants. Second thing is, note down all the names of the participants. Maintain a firm posture. That means your gestures matter more here. That means your body language. Maintain a firm posture always. Take charge of the discussion. Means you should enter into the discussion. Take charge of the discussion. Retain your standing and balance. So maintain your standing and be balanced. Don't keep dangling. Don't get emotional. So when you are speaking something, when you are talking in a group discussion, maintain yourself. Be calm, smooth. Don't go beyond the limits and don't get emotional there. Next, employment interview, that is job interview. What it is? A job interview is an interview consisting of a conversation between a job applicant and a representative of an employer, which is conducted to assess whether the applicant should be hired. So what is job interview? It is an interview consisting of a conversation between a job applicant and a representative of the employer. It is between face-to-face interview. Again, here you're going to face two persons at a time. What it is? They are going to decide whether the applicant should be hired or not. In an organization, if you apply for a job, here the person who is interviewing you or the senior will decide to hire you or no. Interviews are one of the most popular use device for employee selections. So what are interviews? They are one of the most popular use devices for employee selection. So without interviewing, we can't select any employee. So tips or types of interviews. First, I'll give you types of interviews. What are the types, different types of interviews you're going to face? First is telephone interview. The first type of interview is telephone interview. In this, you will have a telephonic discussion. Next, face-to-face interview. So here, face-to-face interview, you're going to answer the interviewer in front of him. Next, the panel interview. Panel interview means a senior or the higher-ups will be asking you and you're supposed to answer them. They'll be posing some questions. A group interview. Group interview in the sense, you have to answer from the group. They will be choosing a person from the group, a candidate from the group. You're going to answer from the group in front of everybody. Formal or informal interviews, planned interview. So here, some interviews will be planned and some will be formal or informal. That is, it will be an official or general interviews. So what is telephonic interview? Telephonic interviews are hugely valuable because they speed up the interview process and minimize time wasting. As I've already told you, telephonic interviews, they speed up the process and minimize time wasting. They don't waste up the time. Next is panel interview. What is this panel interview? Panel interviews are the same as individual face-to-face interviews, but with two or more interviewers in the room. So here, two or more interviewers will be there in the room, and you're going to say, as you have attended the earlier interview, it's nothing but it is face-to-face interview. What is group interviews here? Group interviews are used a lot less regular than the other interviews technique we have mentioned. So here, group interviews are used a lot less regular than the other interviews technique we have mentioned here. Next is face-to-face or individual interview. What is this face-to-face or individual interview? Here, individual or face-to-face interviews are by far the most popular and efficient form of assessment. Here, this face-to-face interview is also known as individual interviews. So what will happen during this time? During this time, the interviews are face-to-face and by far of most popular and efficient form of assessment, allowing you to get up close and personal with each candidate while keeping an eye on their body language is far more effective than any other interviewing format. So here, what they do, they allow you to keep a close watch and with each candidate, keeping an eye on their body language. It is far more effective than any other interview. So what is the summary of this? You should always personalize your interviewing technique, structure, and goal in accordance with your business, industry, and job role on offer. So always what you have to do, you have to personalize your interviewing technique. How you are going to interview that, give an interview that. Structure and goal in accordance with your business, industry, and job role on offer. How and what you are going to give an interview, whether it's on a business process or an industry or a job process. See that what you are going to speak on and maintain a proper interview technique there. Work to your strength and try different techniques to see what works best. So what you have to do? Work to your strength, the maximum, and see that how you can work better, how you can serve better while giving an interview.